Didn't work. Nah, he had to fight them off. They started attacking and they broke one of his ribs.
Hello everybody, you know that I'm Peter's sister, Jan, Fred, Janice.
Fred, Janice?
Jan or Fred?
Well, Fred!
Yes. So Peter.
Frank, Janice, Dan.
What does turning 60 mean?
Exactly.
Rather than brother.
You asking me?
Yes.
You're putting
him on the spot. What does 60 mean? You don't know? I'll tell you.
Yes!
I'm contemplating this question. I came up with the conclusion that when a man reaches 60, two of the most important things in life are bowel movements and nose hair. And 60 fortune tellers read your face instead of your hands. But Peter, in your lifetime, excuse me, I am talking.
You can't pull the crowd like I can.
In your lifetime, you have witnessed so much history. I mean, 60 years, that's a long time. You've gone from inkwells to iPods.
Hey.
While with all this texting, the kids even have their own language, like BFF, best friends forever, or LOL, laughing out loud. So I was thinking, why should we not? Why shouldn't we keep up with the kids and have our own abbreviated form of communication, codes for seniors when texting our friends? Codes like ATD at the doctor's, BFF, best friend's funeral, BTW, bring the wheelchair. And I like these classics. HGBM. HGBM. Has good bowel movement. Or WTFA, wet the furniture again. Oh, all you young foolish ones sitting here listening to us rain on. What a contrast to us wise old ones. You have nose rings, we have bifocals. You have pierced tongues, well, we have dentures. You have ankle braces, and I don't mean that you're criminals, but we have corn pads. But probably, Peter, the greatest aesthetic change for you having reached 60 is your hands have crept up as you got older. Yeah. Soon you will look like a pair of hands with a head. But really, Peter, my brother. But really, Peter, I can tell you that life doesn't change. We're not in. I can't believe this. I usually have the audience enthralled. Well,
they're going to when they don't
get it. They're alive. I can tell you, life doesn't change when you're 60. Well, not that much, except that getting lucky now means you found your car in the parking lot. Peter.
Yes.
You know, I've been introducing myself to That's
weird.
Peter, in all seriousness, I'm so very proud of you and all that you have achieved in your professional field. Starting at Coles, before Coles, Peter Tate, Bill Productions. And then of course, working your way up to manager, getting sacked because you left a key safe on the checkout counter over the weekend.
$25,000 just sitting on the bench.
$25,000 cash sitting on the bench. And then you went into the caring industry, like who gives a fuck industry. Working as a carer for those who are challenged, then gaining your nursing degree, then onto your psych degree, and very quickly starting your professional practice. Yeah.
But you must remember, Peter, not to nod off during your counselling session because you're getting old. Why have you been doing that? You told me.
And there's your wonderful kid, yay!
And haven't given you an ounce of worry.
I don't think you have.
They are a fine reflection of your values and Bernice's nurturing. But for me personally, there have been the occasional times in my life that you have been my anchor. I see you as a peacemaker, and how appropriate. A peacemaker is now married to a pacemaker.
For example,
but he has worked his ass off for us, kids, and for example, he has spoiled us not only letting, like, you know, paying for us, well, I shouldn't say that, but like, when we went to Egypt, and now we're going to America in 4 days or 5 days,
Whatever.
He has, no, like, but, like, what families can say that, like, you know, that we've been going on holidays like that. So, even though sometimes I think, oh my God, shut up, Dad. And when he tries to do the psychology shit on us, we just bloody know, like, you can't do that shit. And he's like, reverse psychology.
I'll leave it up to you.
But no, he has worked his ass off to give us the best that we can ask for, and we appreciate it. And we
want more.
We are very.
We want more. And,
please don't tell your office.
You're
on Collins Street.
I want my dad. But no, thank you, Dad.
No worries. Thank you. Yeah.
Good job, Al. Woo!
Happy birthday, Ben.
Happy birthday, Ben.
My eyes are really cold, but it's actually Ben's birthday today.
Ben was going to say something.
Right,
Ben's going
to say something.
That's what I was going
to say.
No.
No, I was
going to
say, thanks, Dad, for everything. And thank you very much. I would say the only thing I remember is Dad, take the time out every time and teach us everything I know about football.
Yeah.
And how well it's going to be. So.
On your Benno.
Do you like to come up?
Peter Tate. 1956.
Yeah.
Remember that year, Pete?
Don't tell me I'm talking about the
nappies.
Melbourne Olympics.
No, I'm not going to talk about the nappies. I could probably go through about half a dozen anecdotes, but I'll just make this brief. Peter was born in 1956, the year of the Melbourne Olympics. We used to go down, that was the ones that were older than him. I'm the eldest, and then there was Jan never got out.
I'm not the second eldest, I'm the youngest.
But the only thing is, because
you weren't born then.
Why asked you?
This is my brother over here, Lee. What actually happened there, let me finish the story, mate. We used to go down the road to the Heathertons and watch the 1956 Olympics on black and white TV.
And the Mickey Mouse one.
And that too, the Mickey Mouse one. We come home, our mum had this little thing. It's a wonder this guy hasn't passed away. I can tell you for why. Mum used to park his, we'd walk around the back coming out from the... Coming home from the Olympics, this is in November. Mum had parked Peter out in the backyard in the bassinet, and he was like a little pig in him. He was black as the ace of spades. And I said to Mum, you sure that's okay? Oh, sun's good for him. Really, look how brown he is. He's black, he's cold. He took him on the bus one day and they wouldn't let him sit down the front. He said,
you've got to... True story, yeah. But really, I will keep it short because it's going to be a long night. I'd like to just say that, Pete, you've been great, and the family reflects exactly you and everything that you've done. Bernice, you've done a wonderful job with these kids. I'm waiting for a response from Peter.
You have, you've done a marvellous job.
You have, Bernice. And, well done. Yeah, big shigger.
I haven't known, I was fucking working.
And Bernice, you know, with the medical problems she's had just recently, but you've overcome that.
I was going to add,
oh, my God. The old moon boot, yes, here it is then, yes.
It's a dementia we're worried about, not the pace of our
No, all I can say is, Pete, well done, mate.
Thanks, Jim.
All right, see you around.
There you go. Now, we've got another person out there that wants to have a few words about you, a few anecdotes. A good old friend of yours, Steve Perry. Come on in, a bit more music.
Oh, shut up. I don't know how loud this thing goes, but I'd like to say to everybody that
I'm really close.
Yeah. Well, me or this?
It's crazy.
I'd like to say I met Pete about 25 years ago in the fire brigade. Up in Greendale. We had a few beers together and everything was going great. And then all of a sudden, my wife went to the playgroup and she said, oh, I met this lovely woman. And she is. That was, but I call her Niecy. Bernice.
No.
And we've had a great time since. We've always gone away. Father's Day weekend. We did it for about 9-10 years, didn't we?
Yes.
Yes, and I remember that time you got easy drunk.
Yes.
And Peter kicked up a big stink because he had to pack the car that morning.
Oh.
Yes. And that, now, I thought I was coming along to a quiet party today. I thought, oh yes, about 20 people. I never knew you paid all your patrons.
I liked it.
It's family discount.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
No, so we've always gone away together. We went over to Europe together.
Yep.
We had a few little blues over there. Yeah, I remember you telling me up one day because I stepped six inches out of this place and I was in trouble for that. But we have always had a good time. And it's good to see you going away to America. The same week, I'm going to Yarrawonga. Big deal.
Do you want to swap?
What, you may want me to go with your wife?
Yeah?
Best thing I've heard for a while. No offense, honey, you are.
Pop your keys in the bowl.
So we've always had a
good day tonight, boys.
So we've always had a good time together. We've eaten and we've drunk a good bit together. I think your stomach's maybe a fraction bigger than mine. Can't hold me breath that long.
Didn't have lunch today.
So I wish all the best in the forthcoming time here, Peter.
Yeah.
And he's still going into retirement, so he's got to start thinking that way. Yeah. But I've got the way I've come. His hair's this colour. My hair used to be that colour, you know, 10 years ago. I look at my hair now compared to his.
Ah.
It's that Grecian 2000, I reckon.
I'll tell you the reason in a moment.
No.
So, and be up, well, you know, all your friends and friends bring them. Yeah. Wish you the best.
That's right.
For now and always.
Thank you, Steve.
Thank you, Steve-o. Well said.
It's time for the woman of his life to give her speech. And if anyone would like a transcript of her speech after it, I've got it here. Alright, so just ask me for it, I'll go for you. It's just, yeah, really proceed, yeah. There's no running time.
There's nothing on it, Bernice.
I'll just read you a few words. It's a great speech, right? The year was 1956, a little over a decade after the final shots of World War II were fired. Van Zandt was in office, and a cold winter wind was blowing. That's a funny name for a season, Arch thought, as he watched the contractions grow closer and closer, leading to the inevitable conception of Peter John Tote. God, it's a great speech, my boy. You take it away from here, alright? Yeah, it's about a 3-hour, 47-minute speech. And so take it away, the next date.
Oh.
The year was 1956.
Hello everyone, it's so nice to have you all here. Thank you all for your travelling. There's lots of, there's some from Sydney, Adelaide,
woo!
And Gippsland, there's a lot of Gippslanders here.
Yay! Yay!
Shepparton.
Melbourne people, a lot of Melbourne people.
Woo! Woo! Yeah!
I hate sweet sister. The only thing I sort of think should be brought out is the fact that Peter, I've known him since he was 26, not really, though that's an eternity, but there is few men here, Dukes, Ken, Wordy, because my brain freeze is going in, setting in. And who else is there? All went to kindergarten with me, and Paul.
We did not.
So, you did! They didn't go to kindergarten with him, they went to primary school, starting from year one.
Preps.
Yeah.
We didn't know we were kindergarten.
Did you go to kindergarten? Anyway, I think that's pretty good. So 60 years, that's over 50 years, and all those guys are all known. And they're still the very best of friends, and they go. Peter goes down to Melbourne every now and then and has drinks and things with them, and a good old chat.
What else do you
catch up? And yeah, we have all the occasional get togethers like this, which is really nice. So that's
drinks
really good.
And things.
Sorry,
he goes down to Melbourne and has drinks and things.
Oh, I don't know what the things are. So I met Peter when he was 26, and Ben turned 26 today, so.
Oh.
That's
oh.
Ben turned 26.
It's your night, Ben.
Look out, Ben.
It's your night.
No,
gets nothing.
You seem a lot older at 26.
Oh, more mature.
Takes for more mature.
Does anyone say so?
As we all know, I think everyone here knows that the Tates are a crazy family. And
oh, you don't get started!
They're crazy in a beautiful way.
You look shit.
I've known Jean for
Tell us.
Where is this bit?
here now.
Peter is a lovable character, he's a funny character, he's got just about any sort of character in
his mind.
Annoying.
Cartoon, fictional.
I'm interested.
Most of all, he is loving and he's been a wonderful family man, and we really have had a nice life together. And it's going to keep continuing on.
Yeah! Woo!
Well, we hope so.
And just like Eleanor said, you know, he has worked really, really hard, and he still is working really hard late at night, and that's to get his think off.
Lucky you, Bernice.
Think off. That she thinks off.
Which
not many, not all the parents
can say that,
but they all
their family
go in. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, we love you, Peter, and yes, you've done lots of good things. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks, mate. Recently
installed in the right blood pot. 10 out of 10, Ben. That's a 10.
Alright, now it's man of the hour, it's a few thank yous.
Whatever.
Self-hypnosis, having a good time,
so excited.
And a great party.
It's
Peter Tate.
Yay!
Someone said to me this time, because every birthday I have I just get drunk, and I just waffle on, so they said this time, write something down, and I have. Now, I just want to thank all my mates for being here. Yeah, the ones from grade 2 and 3, and the ones from the Greendale pub, which is about 40 years later. And all everyone else who's come tonight, you're here for one reason, is that I really appreciate the fact that you're my friends. And unfortunately, some of you are my relatives. Those relatives that I don't like, they're not here, they're not. And all the relatives, you know, who the was that one? So, I just love you all, and I appreciate you all being here tonight. And I'm having a great time. You've seen all these faces. You've come from all over Victoria, and you've come from the state of there. Oh, Sydney. Who's Sydney? Put up the hand for Sydney. Sydney.
Woo!
And Western Australia. New South Wales. New South Wales down the back.
Welshpool.
Western Australia.
Melton.
Yes.
Backslash.
Well, Western Australia. All the people all over Australia. I really appreciate you. I some of these stories my children have brought up. And it's a bit trouble watching my family. Everyone has a drink in their hand. And I'm thinking, what the hell's going on here? But it doesn't really matter. But the thing about this is that my family has been... You're watching photos. That's my first car that was given to me. I was taking it down the tip, and Ron was the one who towed it down there. And as you go, there's all my car. That's... And that MP Canberra. I've never seen these photos for about 25 years. But it's me.
Lovely dress.
Yeah, I was lucky I didn't go to the I just want to say thank you for everyone for coming here tonight. I've had a great time. My kids are fantastic.
Woo!
We've been through some good times and some great times. And we're going to keep going on these great times. And we do these holidays, not because I want to take them.
It's because I can, and I'm just lucky enough to have a fantastic job, which I really love.
Yeah, I hate my family. I just want to take them on holidays.
Can you hear the secret? Can you all hear me?
Yeah.
All my family in here, without there, that's a lot of clients.
Dennis.
Privacy. I love them and they really need help. And they want to come to my party, they have to make a little bit.
Well,
I just want to say thank you once again for all of my family. Thank you. And she has been a really a pillar. She pulled these kids up. I didn't bring them up because I was working. That's why I can't eat with a knife and fork. She brought the kids up while I was working, and Eleanor's thing, I never thought about that, but Ron did one day say, would you like some carpet? And I said, oh great, where are you getting from? It was the staff room at the back of Smash High School. And I said, I'll have it, eh? It was all full of staples. Thanks, Dennis. I want to kill you. All right. So, okay, keep walking on the stage. So, I remember that. Thank you very much.
Drop the mic.
All right, now it's the final bit. It's time for Dad's cake. Happy birthday, cake. Oh, okay.
It's an emotional night.
Happy birthday, cake.
Even the cake has tears.
It's in the Western world.
Happy birthday. Always getting in your way.
No, you're right, buddy. See you. Drop the mic. Just drop the mic. Just.
Yeah.